have to ask you about this. It's, I see it every day I come here. Mm. It's a crocheted pillow with the face of you, Sarah Silverman, and it's here. We've had it steam cleaned because, well, that's just what you do with anything that's been sitting around the Largo. What is the story?
So many people have sat. I'm sure it's covered in fecal matter and like dried semen.
Yeah.
I mean, it's a little distorted.
Well, first of all, why is there a crocheted pillow with your face on it here at Largo? Explain.
That needs an explanation?
Yes, it does.
Yeah, it does have an explanation. About 5 years ago, I think, I won't go into the whole story, but I almost died.
I remember this.
Randomly.
You had a medical emergency, yes.
Yeah, I had like a abscess on the top of my windpipe. It was either gonna choke me to death or poison me to death if it exploded. You know, like, it's just one of those crazy things. I had a surgery where they told my manager and my boyfriend at the time, like, it was like 50-50 chance of survival.
Oh my
but
God.
I am fine. But I was like in a induced coma for a week.
Wow.
And my other friend named Coco, Mark Coco Cohen,
mm-hmm.
He didn't know what to do with himself. He felt so helpless, you know? And he crochets. And as a matter of fact, when he first started crocheting, he crocheted a huge blanket and he felt kind of emasculated by his new passion, so he wrote the word twat in the middle of it, just like a huge crocheted, anyway.
You know, Grandma Moses made a lot of those. Yeah, that's such a sweet, look for that on Etsy.
He didn't know what to do with himself, so he crocheted a pillow with my face on it,
mm-hmm.
and then when I got to the hospital, he gave it to me, and it meant so much, because I knew it just was made with love.
Mm-hmm.
But then, you know, I live right. in this little apartment.
Right.
And I go,
right.
I was with Flanagan, and I go, I love Mark so much, and I love that he made this, but I can't have a pillow with my face on it in my 3-room apartment. And he said, bring it on down to, I can't do accents.
Oh, bring it on down to the theater.
Bring it on down to the
Gucci heads. We'll kick it around like a Mussolini head.
He said, that's what everybody does with the stuff that they're too embarrassed to have in their house. So like there's like an oil painting of Zach Galifianakis and a Jeff Garland painting. And like everyone just kind of brings it in because
right.
they don't want to throw it out, but they
right.
can't have it in their home.
Right. If it means a great deal to you, but you want it to sit in an abandoned theater, bring it to Largo.
I think that's a Fiona Apple song.
Or the title of her. It probably is. It should be if it isn't.